Antiviruses are a sensitive topic in the privacy and security community, so I will try to stay as impartial as I possibly can. This is a topic that you absolutely need to understand the difference between privacy and security. So if you haven't already seen section 1 of the course where I break those concepts down, you need to go back and watch that. We all know that the internet can be a dangerous place. There are scammers, hackers, but the most frequent issue we hear about is viruses, a form of malware. We've grown up being taught you need to have an antivirus on your computer, unless you have a Mac, or else you will get viruses. This is also pushed by antivirus companies themselves for obvious financial reasons. And these services do everything possible to latch onto your computer, as made famous by John McAfee himself. Go Incognito and all of our other projects that we do are made available completely free to you. One of the ways we're able to do this for a living and offer it for free is through people who are supporting our work. So thank you to all of our patrons over on Patreon, and thank you to our privacy supporters on YouTube. If you want to help enable us spread privacy to the masses, make sure to check out our Patreon and join, as well as becoming a privacy supporter on YouTube. Not only are you helping our cause, but you can gain access to behind the scenes, like how this lesson was created, badges in the YouTube comments, one-on-one consultations, and other cool perks. We really do appreciate anything you can do to help us out, and thank you for your support. Let's start with the pros to antiviruses. They are generally good for your security. They continually scan your system for malware and vulnerabilities, they check every website you visit, scan email attachments, and they can sometimes include tools like password managers and payment-specific security features. But, and this is that big but, it is probably one of the worst things you can do for your privacy. Antiviruses need to scan every file on your computer, every website you visit, and all of your personal data. They almost always collect everything flowing in and out of your computer and admit to collecting this information. Go read your antiviruses privacy policy on their website. For this course, we need to be working towards security and privacy, which makes this a very difficult topic since antiviruses are generally good for security but detrimental to privacy. Every user will have different options, and to figure out where you should go from here, there are three main things you need to answer. 1. How strong is your ability to download from trusted sources with no malicious intent? If you aren't sure, then assume it's not good. 2. What operating system are you using? Are you on Android, iOS, Windows, macOS, Linux, or something else? Different platforms have better security than others, as well as lower targets, which may impact the need for an antivirus. 3. How good are your browsing habits? I covered these tips in our recent lesson teaching the basic rules to avoid viruses, scams, and hackers from invading your system. In short, I will always recommend having some line of defense on Windows as a safety net. To combat privacy concerns, I recommend using Windows Defender for moderate and advanced users. Despite popular belief, Windows Defender is able to compete against most paid options out there. First, it's free. Second, we know that Windows is collecting your information anyway, so using our rules of minimalism, we can simply say, hey, Microsoft already has our information, so let's just use their antivirus to avoid two companies getting access to the same data. I hope this blatant acceptance of data control from Microsoft encourages you to switch over to something more privacy-friendly. We'll talk about more of these options later on in section 4. On the other hand, if you are a beginner and you seriously don't trust yourself, you may want to invest in a paid antivirus for better security. There will likely be a hit to your privacy, but if you can't properly secure yourself, that's a sacrifice you're going to have to make. For macOS, the likelihood of an infection is generally smaller than Windows because it is a less targeted operating system. Advanced users don't typically need anything. Beginners and moderate users may need to use an antivirus for peace of mind, but it's still really not required. If you follow the basic guidelines we've discussed to browse the internet, you should be safe on macOS, but still be cautious because it's more than possible to get infected. On Linux, you almost never need an antivirus, at least as of today. Beginners may want it for peace of mind, but I doubt many beginners will be using Linux in the first place. No matter who you are, I would recommend doing occasional scans using something like ClamAV to make sure nothing slipped. On iOS, no antiviruses, ever. Anything that claims it's protecting you is doing more harm than good. iOS does not need an antivirus, at least as of today, thanks to Apple's heavy restrictions on what apps can be downloaded to the device. Android devices are a bit more open than iPhones. If you're moderate or advanced, you don't need anything. If you're a beginner, you can get one if you download third-party apps frequently, but it's honestly still not recommended. An option for any operating system is to upload a file you download to VirusTotal, a web-based antivirus that utilizes different antivirus databases. It's nice, but do keep in mind that their privacy policy is not very friendly. The last thing everyone watching needs to understand is antiviruses are not intended to do the work for you. They are supposed to be used as a safety net in case anything slips past you. So make sure to follow these tips to protect yourself as much as possible. 1. Go back to the Your Browsing Habits lesson and follow the rules for browsing the internet safely. 2. Make sure you're using a quality firewall, which will stop malicious incoming and outgoing traffic requests. Windows comes with one, macOS has one, although when this script was written, it was off by default, so make sure to enable it in your system preferences. Linux offers firewalls as well. If you're on Android, check out NetGuard for similar functionality. 3. To avoid keyloggers from slipping past your setup, which is when someone or a software captures your keystrokes, a virtual keyboard may help depending on the keylogger's sophistication, or you can use a service like GuardedID to prevent hackers or malware from capturing your keystrokes by scrambling everything you type. Another secret but hidden benefit to using password managers is they eliminate the need to type a password into websites, making them a small defense against the simplest keyloggers. The last tip is to make sure you're aware of your ability to browse the internet safely. Use an antivirus if you think you may need one. Don't be overconfident. To put everything together, I have a love-hate relationship with antiviruses, and you probably should too. They will boost your security, sometimes, at an enormous cost of your privacy. You need to decide whether or not you need one, and that depends on your experience in combination with the operating system you're using. I can't make the final decision for you, but I hope this lesson puts you on the right track. And that's going to wrap up everything I have to say about antiviruses. Thank you for watching this lesson, and I will see you in the next one where I will discuss file deletion and why emptying your recycle bin isn't properly deleting your files. See you soon.